Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I am Kareem Clemens. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for following me right here, right now. This is On The Go with Kareem in the morning. Okay, so what's up, y'all? I'm basically on the go, so I'm basically moving as I speak. And I want to talk to you guys about the breaking news that has now surfaced the airway yet again. With more, okay, of this whole saga that is happening in court right now with the disgraced Jussie Smollett. This mother ucker took the fucking stand. Bitch. I mean, if it wasn't worse already when you lied on national television to the world about what the fuck happened to you when it didn't happen to you. But this bitch took the motherfucking stand. He took the stand, okay? The headlines across this country, okay? And I'll read one of them. Jussie Smollett claims he did drugs and touched one of his alleged attackers. Well, bitch, let me explain something to you. We already knew that there was something going on with him and Austin Durham brothers. Okay? We already knew that. Okay? We was just trying to get down to nitty gritty on the fact is that what happened, did it really happen? Okay? But now we are learning from social media that this mother ucker got on a fucking stand like he in a murder trial. Okay, but no, he is fighting for his life right now. Okay, you know that those jury people are gonna find that ass guilty. Okay, all right, so listen, when I woke up, I was like, damn, bitch, I can't believe it. Jussie Smollett said that he had an intimate relationship with one of the brothers, Abram, Austin Durham, one of two of the brothers who allegedly attacked him in January 2019. Now, let me explain something to y'all. First of all, I believe that the court is closed to the public, but they still getting, you know, fee, do social media, stream, and everything. But listen, right here on Kareem in the Morning, on the go, I want to say this bullshit. Because this is bullshit. And what he said, we already knew. We already knew that there was some type of intimacy or some type of play between them. They already said at the beginning when they were saying, well, yeah, you were going to get your foot long at the subway sandwich. Well, yeah, you were going to the subway shop. Yeah, all right.
It is what it is.
But my thing is this. You got on the stand after all this time has passed and told us. This is exactly what he said. He said, hold on. I want to put this in quote. And the people are going in on the comments. So apparently, they would meet up at a bathhouse and smoke marijuana and do coke and masturbate together. Now, my thing is this. If Jussie Smollett is an actor and he is working on, at that time, Empire and doing all types of other things, how do you have the opportunity to do coke and marijuana and these mother uckers are not testing you before you go out there and work for them? So you got these, you got this mother working while he's under the influence of coke and marijuana. And I know this is not the first time that this happened. There's got to be, I would say, maybe several times. Maybe at this time, it was just that he met up with him and he did what he did. But come on now. This is what I want to say. If the judge and the jury can't go to the attack where the attack happened at, well, the prosecutor needs to bring the attack to the scene, the attack of the scene to the jury and the judge. What I mean by that is this. The prosecutor, if they are smart, what they need to do is they need to get two people, just like, same weight like the Austin Durham brothers, get somebody to pretend they're Jussie Smollett, have them put that mask on their face and demonstrate what happened in that courtroom. On what we know what happened because we put it together. And not what this mother is saying happened, because we already know that this man is a liar. We already know that it didn't happen. And he is still, we don't know. We don't know if this man's testimony is real, but he is still digging a mud hole in Austin Durham brothers' name. Because you got to remember, they have a defamation that they filed against this dude, because everything that they worked for and they did, their businesses done, over because of this. And then when his case got expunged this first time and it was like, oh, well, he's innocent, then that's when people believe that the Austin Durham brothers really played the part in whooping this man's ass, when we know damn well that didn't happen. That was a lie. But if it can't get any worse, this man is continuing to put all this out in social media. And here it is. You had 2020 during the pandemic, 2021, the pre-pandemic. You had all this time to come out on social media to talk about your part of the story. But apparently you didn't. Obviously, you went and you started filming, directing a movie that you did. So the fuck what? That still ain't going to cover what you did. You took the most sensitive thing that people of the LGBTQ and INA, that's lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and questioning, and intersex, and asexual, you took that and you ran with it. And you used something that people are going through every single day in those fields. And that is homophobic attacks, and you filed a falsified crime. And you think that you was going to get away. I don't even want to read these comments online, but I really want to read one of them. somebody said, and this is so sad because the reason why I said the reenactment would do really great in the court is because it will show to the judge and the jury that if it was you and you was being attacked, you want to know who the fuck attacking you. Okay, and I know your attackers are going to attack you. If you attack you, bitch, they're going to attack you and do something that's going to leave you motherfucking disabled. And in this case, he wants us to believe that it was a motherfucking rope and a motherfucking, the substance and that little mark he had on his face, which we found out that was a lie. Okay, so hold on. Let me get into some light. I want to read this comment here that somebody had posted. Again, this is Kareem in the morning on the go, and I want to do this real quick, but I'm definitely going to talk to you guys about this story. But listen to me, I want to read this here. Somebody wrote this: if a chick had been smashing and this was going down on her, vice versa, all of a sudden jumped me in the middle of the night and beat me up and put a noose around my neck and poured bleach on my face with a mask on and yelled, "Mega country," because that's exactly what he did. He continues to says, I would be like, Keisha, bitch, I know that's you. Who the fuck you think you fooling? Somebody comment that. Like, seriously. Like, honestly, you gonna know. And again, you cannot get out of this, man. There is already overwhelming evidence that prove beyond reasonable doubt that you committed this crime. And that is all the testimony, all the evidence, whether or not it is from the check to the testimony to the video capture, the CCTV for when they bought that stuff in the warehouse, or, you know, when the police officer came to his home and he asked the officer to turn off the camera because he had the rope around his neck. That was just so stupid. And I'm not going to forget the fact that this mother ucker committed a crime through the Postal Service by mailing a letter to himself through the mail service and thinking that it was hate crime. Because that's what people do when they want to get at somebody and they can't communicate with them verbally. They want to do it like that. And they want to send out letters. And it's so crazy. And I'll end this here. The letter depicts on everything that happened to him. The stick man had the rope around his neck. There was the gun. And there was the little substance, which we know, which he said it was pee, but we know it was bleach, when we know that shit ain't really happened. But I'm going to tune in later on and give you guys more update information as this saga continues, okay? So this is Kareem in the morning on the go. I'll see you guys in the next video. For more information, you guys can visit the blog page. Now get on out of here, man. We'll be right back.